You know, it doesn't take a genius to figure out that a boss in our business ought to have a zero tolerance for breathing smoke. It's just that simple. And that's pretty much what we said probably, I don't know, 30 years ago, was members of the Phoenix Fire Department are not allowed to breathe smoke. Any time, any place, any situation, simply don't breathe smoke. So we developed a set of sort of organizational dynamics that supported that. In other words, there was indeed a zero tolerance for a smoke inhalation injury. It was just as simple in the beginning of that change as that it was easier to put on your mask than to deal with me. And you would hear firefighters say, the little bastard isn't going away, so it's just easier to wear your mask and you don't have to go through all those acrobatics that you do after they... Because we used to say it. We didn't do it very much, honestly, as we said that if you're overcome by smoke, we will enter search, we'll find you, we'll extricate you, we'll treat you, we'll transport you, we'll visit you in the hospital, and then we'll suspend you. 100